Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will explain how to configure a cascading drop-down list using the SyncFusion Blazor drop-down list. First, let me open the existing Blazor drop-down list Getting Started application, where I have added a Blazor drop-down list with basic properties. I have bound country names as the data source. If you would like to watch the video on the basics of adding a Blazor drop-down list to an app, follow the link provided in the card. You can also find a reference link in the description below. Now, I will run this example by pressing F5. Here, you can see the drop-down list showing country names. Now, let's look at this example, where you can see the series of drop-down list components. Note that, when I select a particular country from the country's drop-down list, the respective state's drop-down list is enabled. Similarly, when I choose a state from this state's drop-down list, the city drop-down list gets enabled. Now, let me show you the steps to render such series of drop-down list components and the steps to configure a cascading drop-down list. To create a cascading drop-down list, first, I need to render a series of drop-down list components by defining one more drop-down list inside the division section. I plan to display estate names in the drop-down list, so let me define two more fields, namely state ID and state name, within this drop-down data model class. Then, I need to create a list of drop-down list data, one of drop-down data model type, and assign an array of objects to it. Now, I will define the t-item and t-value properties with appropriate values to specify the data source type and drop-down list value field type respectively. Next, I will assign this drop-down list data one object to the data source property and map the data source fields, state name to the text property and state ID to value property within this drop-down list field settings tag. Also, this data source contains a list of states, so let me define the placeholder property with the value select a state, which will be displayed in the drop-down list component as the description. And now, you can see the drop-down list components rendered one after the other. Also, notice that the state drop-down list component is enabled and displaying the state names, even though the country drop-down list has no selected value. To disable this state drop-down list and populate the state names only based on the selected country value, I need to write the logic. To do this, I set the enabled property to false by defining the enable drop-down list variable and setting its values to false within the code section. Then, I will assign this variable to the enabled property of the state drop-down list. I will also define the query property to the state drop-down list and set its value to null at initial load. To set it to null, let me define another variable data query with null value. Here, to access this query class, I need to import the Blazor data namespace. Then, I will assign this variable to the query property. I will explain about the need of this query property a bit late. Before I populate state names to the state drop-down list, I need to map appropriate state names to the relevant countries in the first drop-down list component. So, let me add the field country ID with appropriate values, mapping to state's drop-down list data source items. Now, to load data to the state drop-down list component, based on the selected value in the country drop-down list, I need to define the value change event with the relevant handler inside the country drop-down list events tag. Also, I need to set t-item and t-value properties within this drop-down list tag. Next, I will start defining the onCountry change event handler, and then I will form a query to fetch the data items from state drop-down list data source based on the country drop-down list selected value. Here, when a country name is selected, this value change event will be triggered, so within the onCountry change method, enable the state drop-down list component by passing the value true to the enable drop-down list variable. As I said before, to fetch state names based on the selected country value, I need to form a query and assign it to the data query variable. Also, ensure that these variables enable drop-down list and data query are assigned to enabled and query properties of the state drop-down list component. Look at the drop-down list components, the state's drop-down list is disabled. And if I select any country from the country's drop-down list, only then the state drop-down list gets enabled, showing relevant state names based on the selected country value. Like this, you can render n number of drop-down list components and configure each of its value depending on the other. Okay, let me summarize some of the important points now. We have seen how to add the series of Sync Fusion Blazor drop-down list to the Blazor application. We also saw how to configure the cascading drop-down list. If you would like to see a working example of the lists in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.